What if you could travel from DC to Paris in 4 hours, compared to the usual 8 hours of a standard commercial flight? What if you could fly from LA to Seoul in just 7 hours and not 13? Why hasn't air travel time reduced when every other form of travel has seen significant advances and time reductions? The aviation startup Boom is ready to answer all of these questions, and is bringing innovation to the air travel industry with its Boom supersonic overture aircraft. In an era where every sector is accelerating with technology, the aviation sector has taken a back seat. Airplanes have seen little or no improvement in air travel time. In fact, from the 1960s until now, planes have actually become slower than they used to be. So what is it that keeps airplanes from embracing technology and advancing? The answer to that is actually not in technology, but in economics. While a modern-day aircraft flies just below the speed of sound, going much faster than 580 miles per hour has to do with fuel economy. Going faster will mean more fuel consumption and an increase in costs per passenger. Reigniting the Concorde supersonic airliner dream, Boom's model Overture is set to become its successor, infusing modern-day technological advances. The Concorde supersonic airliner came into popularity in 1976 and promised uncharted territories for travel with speeds of 1,340 miles per hour, twice as fast as commercial aircraft of Boeing and Airbus. Traveling at such high speeds meant building an aircraft that was able to withstand high temperatures. The Concorde was next-generation technology at the time with carbon-based brakes and was the fastest commercial airliner available. But being the fastest meant Concorde had to consume more fuel. A regular flight consumed 6,771 gallons of fuel, making Concorde available only to those who could afford ultra-luxury. At the same time, regulators restricted supersonic travel to the ocean due to the noise complaints when it traveled over highly populated cities. The Concorde saw its decline after the Air France Flight 4590 accident. The flight crashed soon after taking off due to a fuel tank puncture, colliding with a nearby hotel and killing 113. The Concorde was discontinued in 2003 after 17,823 hours of air travel. But Boom is fittingly reviving the supersonic dream with three objectives in mind. 1. Reducing travel time. 2. Making air travel costs affordable. And 3. Reducing carbon emissions. Boom's founder and CEO Blake Scholl has a very positive approach to Overture, and expects the company to be in the air by 2023. In a recent interview with CNN, Scholl added that he wants to change perceptions about supersonic travel, where a majority still believe that it's expensive and wasteful. It helps that to remember that we're talking about 1960s technology. So much has changed, Scholl added. And Scholl is right. From the 1960s to now, airplane technology has progressed to using carbon fiber instead of aluminum. Jet engines have made remarkable breakthroughs to be quieter and more fuel efficient. Scholl is also confident that the all-new Overture will be built in a way to support alternative fuels. Taking a look at the aircraft's design, the aircraft will be roughly the size of a Boeing 737, but skinnier, and will carry 65 to 88 passengers with single-seat configurations. The proposed design will have seats on either side of the aisle, with underseat storage. This new supersonic era will be fast, sustainable, and clean. Boom has partnered with Rolls-Royce to advance Overture's engine program design. As a part of the partnership, both companies are working together to identify a propulsion system that will complement Overture's airframe. With its design, business class beds may be optional, because the need for one is eliminated with shorter travel times. The initial focus will be on transoceanic routes, where the aircraft's supersonic speeds will be in use. Cost was a huge factor that affected the Concorde from getting public approval. In the 90s, a return ticket in a Concorde cost between $10,000 and $14,000, making it an ultra-super-luxury travel option. With Overture, Boom wants to bring the cost down to $100, and thus make it affordable to a wider audience of travelers. That's right, $100 to travel anywhere in the world in 4 hours. While this may seem like a pipe dream, this is Boom's long-term goal, after producing maybe two or three generations of aircraft. Boom's Overture timeline has a prototype aircraft ready to fly by the end of this year, and the company hopes to be able to move into a US factory by 2022. The first delivery of an Overture plane is scheduled for 2023. While the big players of the aircraft manufacturing industry, Boeing and Airbus, continue to take the significant share of jetliner production, Boom looks to capitalize on recent opportunities in the market. Boom plans to build a model to eventually be a 100% carbon neutral plane from the ground up and provide a more cost-efficient option for airlines. Boom can come in as a sustainable alternative with all major airlines retiring several planes from their fleet. Interest in Boom is at an all-time high. The company adds that it already has $6 billion worth of aircraft in pre-orders at the time of this video. Virgin Atlantic has already pre-ordered 10 of the $200 million jets. Other airlines have also signed up, and a total of 76 orders are on the books. With Overture, Boom can disrupt the aviation industry if the supersonic jet can fulfill its objectives of being affordable, carbon neutral, and reducing air travel times. If they emerge successful, the day that we'll fly from one major city to another in less than 4 hours for just $100 isn't too far away. And you could say it will be here with supersonic speed. Are you excited for the potential to travel across the world in a fraction of the time for just a few hundred dollars? Where would you go, and who would you take with you? Let us know in the comments below.